Hi, I'm Scotty. I service, repair and restore vintage and antique mechanical clocks. Welcome to Scotties Clock World.
This is a standard 2-inch movement found in all 1950s, 1960s crystal clocks and glass ones too. We'll have a look at the difference in a moment. What we're going to do today is check out the hairspring and install it into the movement. This piece here is the escape wheel. That piece there. And if I can get some light on it, that piece there is the pin pallet. What we're going to do today is we're going to install this piece. That's the hairspring on the top. That is the balance wheel. And that arbor running up and down there is the balance staff. You'll notice that the hairspring is not perfectly flat. It's been raised up on one side. So we're going to repair that before we put it back into the movement. That's what a hairspring should look like. The little bit that's up at the end that gets attached to the movement. If we have a look here, you can see the escape wheel, that piece there. The piece in behind it, just there, that's a lot harder to see. Is the pin pallet. That piece there. Now we had a look at the hairspring a moment ago and we noticed, I'll turn that round, that the spring is not sitting flat. You can see it's high on this side, starting from about halfway around that turn, and running back that way. What we have to do is flatten that spring before we put it back into the movement. And this is how that's done. We'll need two pairs of flat-jawed pliers, unserrated. We take up the balance wheel and have a look at the hairspring, see where the problem is. We'll support that to hold it still, then we'll start work with our pliers. How this is done, we pick up the first place where the wire is starting to bend, hold it gently with flat nose pliers, and then with another pair of flat nose pliers, we flatten the piece slightly to the left. Hold it with your left hand, move the right pliers up, hold it again tightly, left hand, flatten it out, hold with the left pliers, move the right pliers up, and flatten it with the left pliers. What you're doing is holding the spring in the right pliers all the time, and using the left ones to gradually take that kink out of it so that it becomes flat again. This is going to be far too difficult to do it on camera, so I'll do it off camera and then I'll come back. That straightened it out a lot better than it was. There's still a little bit of a bend down the bottom here, but I'll straighten that as I put it into the movement and then put a taper pin on it. Balance wheel fits in there. Between that pivot there and that pivot there. So we undo this adjustable nut at the top with a little spanner I've made to fit it. Then very carefully pick up the balance wheel and fit it in to the bottom pivot, and it just sits there. What we have to do now is align the balance staff and tighten it down into there. Be very, very careful with this, because the slightest mishap and you've destroyed it. Tighten that down a little bit. See what we got in the way of movement. A bit more. So we'll tighten the bottom one. As we're tightening it, we can see the pivot on the balance staff getting closer to where we want it to be. It's getting pretty close now. I'll see how we're going. Won't quite fit, a little bit too close. Back it off. Try to fit the balance staff in again. They're very hard to see. A little bit more, back it off. Now see if that's going to fit in. And I think that is right, and I'm holding it with my thumb very carefully. Right, now you can see I've got the balance wheel in. That was not easy to do. Now we take this end piece of the hairspring, and we've got to put the end in through that, the slot in there. I'll use a pair of tweezers for that. So I can get the end of it. And pull that out without deforming the hairspring again. There. This is very fiddly work. Okay. Pull it through a tiny little bit. Now we have to put the end through that hole in there. Once more with the tweezers. Pop it into there. I'll put a taper pin in to hold it in place. Tighten that down a tiny bit. Here's a good example. Here you can see quite clearly the escape wheel turning, driving the pin pallet. And the balance wheel spinning freely with the hairspring on it.